Casey DeSmith, first game in 23 days. He's won his last two starts, including a 1-0 win against Anaheim December 11th. Sharks starting goaltender presented by Kia is James Reimer, the 33-year-old veteran. He's been very good this season, 11-5-1. Time for the Taco Bell take. Mike Sullivan on the constantly changing roster and schedule. He said so much of it is just out of everybody's control. Just roll with it and make the best decisions for the team. And for the San Jose Sharks, former Penguin Bob Buechner is in his third season behind the bench. San Jose has got them right in the hunt for a playoff spot, just 2 points out in the Western Conference. It's been a while, but we're kicking off 2022 with some Sunday afternoon hockey in Pittsburgh. Off we go. With the Penguins and the San Jose Sharks meeting for the first time this season. Sidney Crosby joined by Jake Guentzel and Brian Rust. The two wingers are back. Of course, Jake Guentzel, the hottest player in the league at the time of his injury. 12 goals in 13 games. So reunited with Crosby and Rust. Quick opening shift, staying on though is Guentzel. And he gets rammed to the boards by Middleton. Got it around the wall and loose in the circle. Tap forward by Barabanov and away is Timo Meier. Meier for San Jose. Drops the shoulder, slips it right in front. Kicks around off the stick and will be covered up by Casey DeSmith.
Both teams have an agenda, and that's get off to an early start. Get on your toes. The Penguins want to do that certainly after a long layoff. The Sharks have played a couple of games in the last week and coming off an overtime victory.
Now that is an interesting dynamic, isn't it, with the Penguins and the 2 weeks off. Two games for San Jose, as Bob said, two wins at a wild 8-7 game against Arizona. And on Thursday, overtime win against the Philadelphia Flyers. Jonathan Dahlin flips it in behind. Activating is Brent Burns. Couldn't filter that one through. It was blocked by Heinen. Quick up Rodriguez. Here come the Penguins looking for a 2-on-1. Rodriguez to the inside. He's got a chance. Fires. He scores! What a play. Another rocket from Erod. 1-0 Pittsburgh.
Nothing can stop this guy. Not even COVID. And here it is. Down the off wing. The advantage of being a right shot, patience, go to the middle as everybody moves ahead. You have that drive by Simone to bring bodies with him. Oh man, that is just spectacular. We've seen that patience and that shot from Rodriguez all season long, and he picks up right where he left off.
Could you have a better start than that? And it's Evan Rodriguez who provides the opening tally for the Pittsburgh Penguins on home ice in their return. And the career year for Erod continues, 11 goals. There's Vlasic with a long shot. That's Scott Nieto on the rebound. It's taken in behind.
Oh, nice job by DeSmith to get out there and front the man and prevent him, Nieto, from not getting that angle there. It looked like he had a little bit of a sliver, but DeSmith took it away.
Three veterans on this line for San Jose with Matt Nieto. Former Penguin Nick Benito and Andrew Pogliano. There's the scoring summary out of Quinn Park University. Pedersen, Heinen get the assist. And the Penguins with a 1-0 lead. Matt Nieto, end of a long shift, flings it right on net, and that's knocked aside by Casey DeSmith. Defending is Letang along with Dumoulin. Dumoulin steps up to the puck, takes some contact, left it for Letang, and he'll start the charge for the Pens. Good lead pass to Radim Zahorna over the line with Lafferty. Lafferty in front for Zahorna. Horner ridden off by Erik Karlsson. Goes forward, Jonah Gadjevich, number 42. Pretty good checking line, like the play of this line for San Jose. Gadjevich along with Peterson and Biel. Puck is worked back as Casper Bjorkqvist pursues, but it's an icing call. Bjorkqvist wearing number 20, first National Hockey League game, 24 years of age, third year pro.
Take a look at DeSmith's work, you know. His puck comes in off the stick of Vlasic, and look where he is. He's in position to kind of man up against Nieto because he didn't lose his footing there at all. So really good stuff. And, I think the Penguins answered the question. Could they start? Could they get that early jump? Yes, they are ready to play. And we started with the Crosby line and continued right on.
Puck comes back to Brent Burns. Shot attempt gets blocked. The follow-up never got through. It's cut off by Sam Lafferty. So it's Lafferty Zahorna who is back. Ninth National Hockey League game for him. And the aforementioned Casper Bjorkqvist in his NHL debut. So Horna's still out there, slides it across. Away is Jake Guentzel. Guentzel points in 13 consecutive games, not officially a point streak because of the injury. But he's got points in the last 13 in which he's played. And Brian Russ back after missing 11 with a lower body injury. Remember, he got hurt in a warm-up on Long Island on November 26th. Here is Russ shifting his way in. Brewer back in front, and it's Gensel. He scores! Jay Gensel doesn't miss a beat. He's back, and it's 2-0.
Well, it was a play that wasn't even intended for Gensel. And it's the guy going to the net. Russ is going to shake and bake. Look at the Penguins. The charts are changing. They get the puck away from the bench. That's the key, number one. Number two, look at this. You got defenseman going to the net. Pettersson misses it, but it goes right to the tape of Gensel, who's over in the corner. And how could Reimer have expected that? He dropped the stick. He couldn't make the save. Boy, Gensel's... he's as hot as they come. It may not be counted as a streak. To me, it's a streak, and he continues.
13 goals in 13 games. The goal's 2 minutes and 9 seconds apart, and the Penguins flying in the early going against San Jose. And Jake Gensel chops this one ahead. Here come the Penguins again on a 2-on-1. Crosby, Ross down the middle, looks, fires, stopped by Reimer.
And that hits into the screen. They're going to have to blow this one down. But you mentioned an 8-7 game that the Sharks played. Their first game back, Mirzi, and you can see why. Boy, are they porous. And if you play the right way, you're going to get rewarded the other way. They're the Penguins. The Sharks already taking chances, pinching when they shouldn't. A 2-on-1 here. And luckily, Reimer makes a save for the San Jose Sharks. There'd be 3-0 right now.
Brian Rust was also playing very well at the time of his injury. Shot by Rodriguez is answered by James Reimer. Rust had 9 points in 12 games, but was injured in the warm-up on Long Island. And was listed as week-to-week, so 2 weeks off, and the Penguins able to heal up, still missing a lot of important players. Getting those two top wingers back. And they immediately have an impact, including Jake Gensel. And his leading scorer, and team leading 28 points. Another odd man rush of 3-on-2. Heinen to the inside. Rodriguez, another chance. He scores! He can't be stopped. Evan Rodriguez, 3-0.
Now, Bob Bugner might want to call a timeout here. His team absolutely leaving the back door wide open with no consideration to play defense at all. This reminds me of some of the games from the Lemieux day, Mirzi. These opportunities, they're coming left, right, and center. Great play here. Rodriguez turns it to the backhand, elevates over the right pad. It's going to be a timeout for the San Jose Sharks here. And the Pittsburgh Penguins have come out in a 1 o'clock game, and they are absolutely smoking hot right now. Hey, listen, the people in California, they're just finishing their coffee watching this game.
It is an early start. Those goals 59 seconds apart. 2 for Evan Rodriguez in the period. He's got 12 goals. Well past his career high. 8. Evan Rodriguez. Along with Jake Gensel, his 16th. And the Sharks are shell-shocked.
Well, you might want to play this up and down game against some teams in the National Hockey League. Not against the Penguins right now. They play the right way. They won their last 7 hockey games. It doesn't matter who's in the lineup and who's not. They just keep coming back and coming back at you, playing the right way, and they're being rewarded for it right now.
Trying to knock it down, Sam Lafferty. Battling for it, Zahorna. Bjorkqvist got a piece with the Sharks. Just trying to get stabilized now and countering with that checking line I mentioned earlier. Lane Peterson, number 18. Shoulder dropped into him by Letang. Zahorna shoveled it forward for Bjorkqvist. And now it's Sam Lafferty picking up speed. Tapped over the line for Dumoulin. Sam Lafferty inside position on Brent Burns. Got a couple of Norris Trophy winners on the blue line. The Sharks with Burns and Eric Karlsson. To the point, John Marino. A pinch from Pettersson. The puck comes to Brent Burns. We'll take a look up ice. Penguins with 3 goals in their first 5 shots. Sharks with 2. Rock again will get it deep. Jacob Middleton, accurate pass, and away is Noah Gregor. Gregor flying it down the wing. Got a little curl and drag around Pedersen, gave him nothing. Drew O'Connor will take it away. Dangerous pass the middle, but fought off by Pedersen. Forward, played by Aston Reese. James Reimer has been very good this season. Maybe their MVP, not much he can do here with the odd man rushes. And the Penguins with the finish in the first 5 minutes. Two goals from Evan Rodriguez, one from Jake Gensel, team leading 16th. And Pittsburgh off to a great start in their return to the ice.
Fans just got in their seats here. Welcome to this little treat right after Christmas.
Gensel's back on along with Rust and Crosby. Works back to the point, Dumoulin. Across the Letang, tried a shot, blocked by Barabanov, comes to Rust, he fires, he scores! And this onslaught continues, Brian Rust is back!
You know, sometimes you never get a bounce. You go 10 games, it doesn't bounce your way. Watch this puck bounce back to Rust. Here's a shot from Letang, goes off a body, off the skate of Rust, he corrals it. Goes right down the middle of the ice, and Reimer, he's sitting in the blue paint. Plays deep, not cutting down any of the angle. And it's a perfect shot right in the six hole for Brian Rust. That good, quick release there from straight on, and the Penguins are up 4-0 in Pittsburgh.
After missing 11 straight games, Brian Rust has his third goal of the season. Dealt with a couple of injuries or stints on the injured list. Got hurt in the second game of the year. And that first line that has so much chemistry, played together so much in the past, not as much here this season because of various injuries. Stints on the COVID protocol list, but Rust, Gensel, Crosby, they're back, haven't missed a beat. And it's 4-0 Pittsburgh, four goals on six shots. Evan Rodriguez trying to work it up the boards. Held in by Carlson. Flipped to the middle. Blocked away. Ben's trying to home run pass and breaking up ice is Dan Hyde. And puck never got there on the cutoff by Carlson. We got to give the Penguins a lot of credit for the way they practiced. A lot of scrimmaging. And they want to be ready to go. You know they emphasize the start of this game and being ready after the layoff. Five full practice days. Tried to simulate game action, and that work has paid off.
And they're winning the battles to the pucks. Look, even right here, they just win every battle to the puck.
3-on-2 now for San Jose. Marc-Edouard Vlasic, the veteran defenseman, chips it in. Jonathan Dahlin, number 76. In after on the forecheck for the Sharks. Dahlin along with Tomas Hertl, always seems to score against the Penguins. 9 goals in 12 career games against the black and gold. Hertl winds it around. Malosh with the shot, and that came back in front of DeSmith. Penguins able to sweep it away. And Radim Zahorna gets it to Casper Bjorkqvist, and he will float it into Sharks ice. Marc-Edouard Vlasic in the turn back. 16th year in the NHL for Vlasic, all with San Jose. DeSmith will drop it off. Tang lost control as he was pressured. Fired forward, Brock McGinn, Letang. Had to filter that one through, intended for Aston Reese or O'Connor. It doesn't work, and on the counterattack, it's the Sharks with Logan Couture. Barabana takes the handoff, pulls up, just swarmed by three Penguins and Dumoulin. Trying to get it out, couldn't, but Letang will. Brock McGinn breaks in, McGinn looks, fires, missed upstairs. And glanced off of Burns. No Teddy Bluger this afternoon for Pittsburgh, so Drew O'Connor taking the place at the third line center with Aston Reese and McGinn.
These two teams have played a 10-8 game, Mirzi. You know, the Penguins lost that one. They won 10-2.
Crosby in with a shot, and that's denied by Reimer.
Well, Reimer made a save with the glove hand, and Crosby's flying, as are everybody in a Penguins uniform in that third jersey, which looks beautiful.
Now it's Brian Rust, give and go. Crosby, Rust on the backhand, missed the target. Around to Chad Ruedel, with that one all the way through. Back around to Mike Matheson. Punched along for Crosby. Crosby to the middle, trying to accept it was Matheson. Falling down Crosby, wanted to spray it in front, but then gets blocked. And again, the Sharks are trapped in their own end. Dominic Simone trying to keep that puck there. Crosby cuts across. protects it neatly. It'll leave it at the blue line. Finds the late man, hopping on with Danton Heinen. Collects and shoots, and that's off of Reimer. Penguins winning every battle here in the first period. Matheson with the drive. That gets blocked. Rodriguez already with two. Drag, shoot, stopped by Reimer.
Oh, man, that close to his first National Hockey League hat trick for Rodriguez. He's got four career two-goal games.
Fans responding. What a ship from Pittsburgh again. Matheson blasting, stopped it, rebound, and it's chopped away by Middleton. All the way down it goes. That's going to be an icing. Sharks won't be able to change. And the Penguins, total domination in the first 10-plus minutes.
Well, look at the Sharks leaning on their sticks here right now. Bonino, the former Penguin, all of them, they just gasping for air right now. Rodriguez looking for the trick. Right-hand shot coming off the left side. He's got a wicked shot, and it's a little bit of a delayed release sometimes. He holds it for that extra second and really makes the goaltender. Kind of freezes the netminder as he did on his initial goal here tonight.
Sharks are able to control off that faceoff and will gain the line and get it deep. The shot's 10-3 Pittsburgh, 4-0. Rodriguez, two goals. Gensel with one, Rust with one. Both those players returning to the lineup and getting in the goal column. We wondered how this game would go. We've seen some wild games over the years coming out of bye weeks and Olympic breaks. Nino over to Pettersson. He'll fake. Pressured by Peterson. The puck leaks out to center. Nice of the Penguins are able to continue with the exact same defensive pairs. They've had a lot of continuity with that. Despite all the players who've been in and out of the lineup, all the roster shuffling that's been done, they've had consistency with the defensive pairs over the last couple of months. Tomas Hertl is going to touch this one as he was reaching. It is offside, and everybody can catch their breath. Pittsburgh Penguins, an incredible start. Two goals, Rodriguez, Gensel, Brian Rust as well. 4-0 for the Black and Gold.
Well, we've got a long way to go, and it's 4-0 Penguins here in the first period. And earlier this week, the Coyotes and Sharks combined for 15 goals. That includes San Jose's game winner in the shootout. We have not seen that many in a game since 2019. And who remembers the Penguins and Caps in 2017? They put up 15. Better yet, who remembers the 18 goals between the Penguins and the Sharks on January 13th, 1996? Fire wagon hockey.
Dan, thank you very much. Nice sweater, by the way.
Ugly sweater, by the way.
I was going to say it's not ugly. What are you talking about?
Very ugly.
It's a handsome guy there.
Very ugly sweater.
Gino gave you the nod on that, did he?
Yes, he did. I know he's watching downstairs in the room. Okay. Thank you, Gino.
Can't wait to get him back.
And he spoke with the media a few days ago. He's very close to a return, hoping to get back in the lineup, make his season debut on the Penguins' upcoming road trip, which will take them next week to Dallas and then out west to California. These two teams will meet again in 13 days in San Jose. Puck is fired across to Timo Meier. Meier rips that one wide to Casey DeSmit. DeSmit with three saves. All the action has been on the other side of the ice. And how many times, Bob, have we said it's a matter of keeping it going? I don't know if you can continue with this type of pace for a full 60 minutes, but just not allowing San Jose to claw back in any way. Think back to the home opener against Chicago. We've seen it time and time again. Got a lot of hockey to be played.
A lot to be played, but there is a team that's, well, they're playing like Sharks, and that's the Penguins. They're the hungrier team right now.
Inching is John Marino. He settles down a little bit. And it's lobbed out to center, knocked down by Crosby. Got it to Pettersson.
Lord Gattura out there in his 800th career game.
Here's Crosby looking for Rust out of his reach. Rust to the glove of Crosby, lost possession. There is Couture and ahead for Cogliano. Cogliano along with Matt Nieto. Trying to get to the puck, but getting there first was Marcus Pettersson. Andrew Cogliano, very dependable player in his career. 15th year in the NHL. Dominic Simone to Danton Heinen. He's got two assists in this first period. Mike Matheson spinning in front. Rodriguez, and it's tapped wide. Evan Rodriguez looking for three.
These guys are just dancing right now. Simone, and then Heinen, and then Matheson with a little ballerina move.
How about the second line with no Jeff Carter, no Kasperi Kapanen today? Not missing a beat. Going with Evan Rodriguez back at center. Of course, he's played just about every position this year. Dominic Simone getting a top six chance to poke check by DeSmith. Comes back up high. Šimek with the drive, and that's off bodies in front.
Boy, that hit a shark right in front of the net after the turnover.
Good speed from Lafferty. Looking to glove it down. And he used the horn out there, number 67. Ninth National Hockey League game. Out of the fray, Lafferty. Lafferty, shoved down by Burns. Wayne Peterson cops it up. Bjorkqvist. Rishut is gloved down by James Reimer. 6:02 remaining in the first period. All Pittsburgh so far. 4-0 for the Preds.
Well, we were just talking about Evgeny Malkin's sweater, so let's talk about Geno Sweating. Our UPMC Sports Medicine injury update. Earlier today, Evgeny Malkin on the ice, practicing once again, and man, does he look good. The veteran says that he continues to get stronger and stronger. He hopes, as he told us on Wednesday, that he can return to action maybe as soon as the Penguins' upcoming trip out to the West Coast. No confirmation of that, but we will certainly keep our fingers crossed. Gotta like it.
Definitely, Dan, thank you very much. So his knee feels 200%. Looking forward to seeing him back in, hopefully very soon. He's been taking the line rushes, taking contact in practice. And Evgeny Malkin close to his season debut. Pittsburgh today without Carter and Kapanen, as I mentioned, along with Teddy Bluger, Brian Boyle, Tristan Jarry. Casey DeSmith. So far for him, 3 saves. DeSmith has won his last 2 games. For his first career win against San Jose, 0-2. Shot by Hurdle, answered by DeSmith. On the rebound was Zach Aston-Reese. Drew O'Connor getting a chance to play center on his third line. In the Bluger spot, Letang. Lead pass, Aston-Reese. Cutting it 2-on-2, the dropper, McGinn, charging toward the net. His shot goes wide. Around to Pettersson, looking for O'Connor. Spins that one on goal, Reimer with the save. Brock McGinn, this line buzzing. Missed by O'Connor in front, but back to Marino. Marino angles it over. McGinn's shot gets blocked. Zach Aston-Reese keeps the pressure on for Pittsburgh. Joined by Drew O'Connor, Timo Meier. Sharks' leading scorer. Now Barabanov. Lobs it into the corner. Meier.
A lot of shots going to the blocker side. Mirzi on Reimer here tonight. I believe all 4 goals have been scored on that side.
Like I said, Reimer's been very good this season. Maybe their MVP. 2-year deal in July. Tip try in front by Barabanov. He scores. And the Sharks are on the board. Alexander Barabanov redirects that puck in. It's 4-1.
Yeah, you just throw the puck to the net. And Burns has been doing that for years. And he just gets it to the front of the net. Always one of the leaders in shots. Vlasic, another defenseman. Sorry, Meyer, excuse me, just wrists it in. Barabanov knocks it down with the bottom of the shaft of the blade. It lays down right on that goal crease, and DeSmith, who's moving right to left, can't stop himself to get in position to make that save. So, well, 4-0's a good lead to have, but it was early, and it is early in the hockey game. There's enough offense on this Sharks team that they can make something happen, so there's a lot of hockey left.
What did Dan say, 8-7? We are on our way, aren't we?
8-7, 10-8.
This is like early 90s Penguins Sharks so far. See if it continues.
Well, we saw one hockey team leading a game 4-0 and then lose yesterday. Carolina came back to win that hockey game when being down 4-0. So you never know.
Let's take a look at our barrel forward leaders looking back at the calendar year of 2021. Penguins point leader was Jake Guentzel, 84. How about Tristan Jarry, one of 2 goaltenders in the calendar year with 40 wins, Andrei Vasilevsky being the other one. Penguins notched 116 points, 30 wins on home ice. Faceoff win in the attacking zone, and sent off the end wall by Rue Wiedel. Collected by Nick Bonino, good to see him back in Pittsburgh, 2-time Stanley Cup champion. Icing called against the Sharks.
Former Shark draft pick, Bonino, wearing the 13. Here's a look back, Mirzi. Remember that beard, you remember that line, and you remember that cup for sure.
One-third of the HBK line with Carl Hagelin and Phil Kessel. Nick Bonino played in 143 games regular season with Pittsburgh, 45 in the playoffs.
He's a good player here, real good.
There's another one of those versatile guys, right? We saw him in a bunch of different roles, so important. In those cup wins in 2016 and 2017, got a two-year deal in July. As Bob mentioned, the team that originally drafted him, the San Jose Sharks. Right in front, Bjorkqvist with a chance, it's loose, and they score! The Penguins get it back. Radim Zahorna was in there. Kasper Bjorkqvist might just have his first NHL goal in his first game.
I think he's got it, folks. And you get yourself to the front of the net, you can get rewarded. The kind of game that he plays, he goes to the front of the net, he keeps it simple, crash and bang, and maybe get a bounce. There's Ruedel, gets it back to Lafferty, and they just get the puck to the front of the net. And yes, it's gonna be his goal. He gets down low on the puck. It goes five hole on Reimer, and it trickles across the goal line, I think, before any other Penguin touches it. And everybody remembers that first goal in the National Hockey League. And I think Bjorkqvist has got it right now, and good for him. Congratulations.
5-1, just the response the Penguins were looking for after the Barabanov goal. I'll wait on the official scoring, but Kasper Bjorkqvist with an impact in his first NHL game. 24 years of age, second round pick. He's just dealt with a lot of injuries, hasn't been able to play since turning pro. Letang looking for Crosby's stick in front.
Boy, and that's a Crosby redirect across the body again with the front of the blade.
Back it comes to Dumoulin. Dumoulin again, the tip try Crosby, and the puck goes wide. Rust and this Crosby line. Domination. Letang, Rust redirected and goes wide of the net. Penguins continue to tilt the ice. Off the bench, Drew O'Connor. Lost the handle, skips over. Nadim Šimek couldn't connect cleanly with Peterson. Peterson's got it now, stepped into by McGinn. Stick handle away from him, but the puck stolen by O'Connor. Tang will lay it in. Drew O'Connor along with Brock McGinn and Zach Aston-Reese. Six goals on the board. Still up 2:18 to go in the first period. O'Connor dangling, fire, stopped by Reimer. Kasper Bjorkqvist, get that puck. First NHL goal, it's 5-1 Pittsburgh.
There's a look, 5-1, and we're gonna take one more look on our Supermo, presented by AHN. First career National Hockey League goal. It just trickles across the line for the, well, I'm sure he watched the finish flash do it many a times, and he's looking to make a name for himself in the National Hockey League. The second round draft pick for the Pittsburgh Penguins back in 2016. He's got one in the league.
Played only six games in 2019-20. Look out, here comes Hurdle, dances in, and he's denied by Casey DeSmith. Tomas Hurdle, top goal scorer for the San Jose Sharks. Always seems to get one against the Penguins. Almost had one here.
Well, nice little flip pass there. Hurdle is so big. He's got a great presence. He's got long range. Tough for a goaltender. He can move it left to right. He's got great hands. Another look at that. And a super move presented by HN. And Thomas Hurdle, one of the hottest players in the National Hockey League right now.
Another shot comes into Casey DeSmith. And deep in the crease, he's able to make the save. We'll get a message from Sheely's Furniture, Appliances, and Mattresses.
Penguins Hockey is brought to you by Sheely's Furniture, Appliances, and Mattresses, the official furniture and mattress supplier of the Pittsburgh Penguins.
A couple of big saves for Casey DeSmith here. We'd have seven in the first period. 5-1, we just have the six. Well, we're a third of the way to 18. You never know.
Bob, you played in some of those ridiculously high-scoring games, the early days of the San Jose Sharks. Those were the nights where Mario was guaranteed 4 points.
He was guaranteed.
That Cow Palace.
10-2 win there in 1991.
The old expansion teams in the 90s that were just outmatched. with the powerhouse Penguin team.
Mike Sullivan was on some of those other teams, but he was playing for San Jose in the early days of the Sharks.
Original Shark, yes. Mike Sullivan. With San Jose from 91 to 93. Logan Couture, Sharks captain on the backhand, bosses that one to the crease. And that's gobbled up by Casey DeSmith. Coming up in the first intermission, presented by your neighborhood Ford store with Robin Jay. And Potash will be speaking with Casper Bjorkqvist. Highlights and analysis. First National Hockey League game, his first goal. Played mostly in the Finnish League last year. As I mentioned, with the injuries, shoulder and knee injuries and serious ones, hasn't played all that much, certainly not in North America. He's a third-year pro.
Solid guy. You know, he does those things that coaches appreciate. Block shot, get to the front of the net, bang a body or two, play on the right side of the puck.
Marcus Pedersen sizing it up. Shot attempt is knocked down by Vlasic, but the Sharks can't get it out. Crosby with a one-timer. Sails to the glass. 45 seconds to go, period number one. A 5-1 score. And this Crosby line has been so effective in getting the puck to the offensive zone, keeping pucks alive. They do it here. Crosby's open. Gensel with it. Goes up high. Pedersen blasting. Missed the net. Marino. Rust with the shot. Score! Brian Rust! 6-1. Pittsburgh in the first.
Six to one. And look where Rust is. He's a forward. And that goes off a body by Reimer. And for poor James Reimer, he might have 27.2 seconds left in this hockey game.
On the backup for San Jose, Zach Sochenko has never played in the NHL.
Well, he better be getting his equipment ready, because there'd be no rhyme or reason for him to be back in the second
period.
I
knew you were going there. Here's Gugliano with a shot. That's fought off by DeSmith. McGinn looking for one more chance. One-on-one against Middleton. Dragged to the inside of the backhand off the post.
What a move by McGinn. They almost.
Everybody to their feet. The Penguins. A 6-1 lead that was almost 7 with Brock McGinn. Of a move and catches the Zach Sochenko, 24-year-old from Calgary, Alberta. Numbers from the American Hockey League as he's played in 9 games. So this is his first National Hockey League action. Reimer pulled Sochenko in, and Bob will look back at the first period specifically for Brian Rust in his return.
Well, you know, a quick release here on the blocker side, and that Penguin Crosby unit is back on track. And there's the final one to really end the period and end Reimer's day. I don't think he was coming back anyway. It's 6-1, and that's what the top line has done so far this afternoon.
A combined 5 points, 6 shots on goal. Gensel making his return after missing 5 games. Sidney Crosby doing his usual thing. A couple of shots on goal. At 1 point, almost tipped one in for a goal of his own. And Brian Rust, 3 points, 3 shots. Ruedel and Matheson are +3 each. Social media post brought to you by Point Park University. Yeah, fireworks left over from New Year's. We still have a long way to go. Sarah says, can anyone stop E-Rod at this point? 12 goals for Evan Rodriguez. Casper Bjorkqvist, 23rd player to make his NHL debut with the Pens and score in that game. Some memorable names, memorable moments on that list. And we're underway in the second period. We have seen some wild scores with teams getting back from the break, the extended holiday break. Usually that has benefited the team that has played, like San Jose. So they've played 2 games since their holiday break. They had 3 games postponed. And then a lot of times you see some rust. Not the case for the Pittsburgh Penguins after having 5 of their games postponed. Shot for Carlson is kicked away by DeSmith. Evan Rodriguez will chip it out the center. 2-on-1 for the Pens. Danton Heinen, early with 2 points. Heinen fires, upstairs it goes.
Still trying to go blocker side of the Penguins, even with the new netminder in. Ryan Russ had not played since November 24th, an extended layoff for him, and he is flying as well tonight.
3-on-2, San Jose, Cogliano, skitters to a stop, lost control of the puck, and it's skated out by Evan Rodriguez. Rodriguez the draw for Heinen, looking for Rodriguez along the ice with Bonino to block it neatly. And Heinen keeps it in the attacking zone. Sticks in the corner for Rodriguez, but he works it around to Matheson. Side of the crease, Sachenko will handle the puck for the first time. Well, the points are so critical, even at this stage, and even with the Penguins' 7-game winning streak, still have been able to get into the top three, but now they have games in hand because of the postponements. Trying to get a little closer to the New York Rangers in the Metropolitan Division standings. It's Carolina, Washington, and the Rangers. So we have yet to see the Rangers. We have yet to see Carolina this season. There are big division games that will be around the corner waiting for Pittsburgh. Up next for the Pens will be Wednesday in this building against the St. Louis Blues, who won the Winter Classic yesterday. Penguins looking for an 8-game winning streak. It will be their first since 2018-19. Drew O'Connor working with Zach Aston-Reese and Brock McGinn. Puck is floated out by the Sharks and striding back, Chad Ruedel. As I mentioned, Ruedel and Matheson, plus three each. Penn's able to continue with the same defensive pairs this afternoon.
Now you mentioned about talking about days off. So this year, the best record's 2 days, two plus days off. Florida 8-0-1. The Sharks are number two, 6-1, and the Penguins are right there at 7-1-2. But when the Penguins all time have four plus days off, 14-3 all time.
Middleton with a headhunter. Pulled the mask up, Casey DeSmith. Can't emphasize it enough, the way the Penguins practice this week, simulating game action. And they were long practices too. A couple times they resurfaced the ice in the middle of it because they were so long, but they wanted to replicate game action, get some scrimmages in, some battle drills. And there's no question, this team ready to go this afternoon against San Jose. Middleton whips it around for Timo Meier. Meier on the backhand. Puck comes to open ice. Rust for Crosby. Crosby falling down, plays it, and off the bench. Play stops. We'll get a message from Rivers Casino.
Treat yourself to a night out you'll never forget at Moderano's Prime at Rivers Casino Pittsburgh.
Crosby went down rather awkwardly there. Took a look over the official, thought maybe he was tripped up trying to make a play on the board. Not so sure, he just didn't step on a stick there. And you talk about being sharp, and it's all led by 87 on the ice. And then you follow up, you got Gino, he's ready to go. Gensel and Rust are back in, and they're ready to go. So you talk about that practice, and yes, it does start from your captain.
They're just so hungry to play some games. These are guys that are used to playing at least three times a week. If they go 2 weeks with no game action. The Penguins led by Crosby and, of course, Mike Sullivan. The practice plan, ready to go right at the drop of the puck. They scored 1:03 in. Evan Rodriguez got his first of two so far on the day.
And I don't even know if he was a guy that would have been able to play this afternoon had they not changed COVID protocols from 10 to 5 games.
Good point, yeah.
I don't know if he would have been able to don the Penguins jersey here this afternoon.
Yeah, really good point. Pittsburgh still without Malkin. Jason Zucker also, I haven't mentioned him. He is now out week to week. Lower body injury. That had been a nagging injury for Zucker. He missed some practice then, so obviously he was fighting through that and playing the games, but then unable to go, so he's listed as week to week. Ryan Boyle, Jeff Carter, Tristan Jarry. So yeah, they are healthier, but certainly not at full health. Those are key names that are out. The Penguins dominating. Gets a little bit of a wraparound, and Sachenko leans over to his left to get to the post.
I didn't think he had a chance to do that, but he almost performed surgery there, did Gensel.
Tomas Hertl stopping. Brings it in behind. Looking for Noah Gregor, but it was broken up by John Marino. Marino leads it out to center and leads the stick of Rust, and Jacob Middleton will rewind for San Jose. San Jose kicking off a 4-game road trip. It's their third game back after having three postponed, but they've won the last two, 9 of their last 15. Marcus Pettersson will step up. Connects with Evan Rodriguez all the way across to Marino. Marino gains the line, fires it in. Sachenko stays in the crease. Hoisted out by San Jose. Andrew Cogliano will lead it for Matt Nieto. Nieto absorbs the contact from Matheson. Weedle getting back. Twisted around by Cogliano. Dominic Simone was helping out. Matt Nieto drops it in behind. Puck available along the wall. Matheson, nice play, takes it away. Charging down the wing. Got some space. Matheson leans in, fires off the bar. Another post from Pittsburgh, and again, it's almost seven on the board. Matheson gets back to his defensive position behind the Sharks' goal. Simone, Aston Reese on the backhand. Puck trickles back to the line. Mike Matheson. Redirection, Aston Reese tonight. Side of the net, Dominic Simone working hard. This line has been really good. Right now it's Rodriguez out there. Simone all the way over. Brian Dumoulin works the top with Mike Matheson. Whiffs on it. Puck came out. Dumoulin can't touch it. And reloading will be Nieto.
Penguins has six players on the ice for about 10 good seconds right there. It's an afternoon game, and the referees want to keep it going at 6-1.
I have yet to have a penalty this afternoon.
I guess I just,
I don't know who gets the blame for that.
Yeah, I don't know.
Might be me. Radim Šimek. Pass attempt gets blocked by Letang. Nemo Meyer was fishing for it. Dumoulin protects. Rink wide, Drew O'Connor. Tangled up with Brent Burns. And it's Jonathan Dolan who will lean in. Dolan tries a centering pass. Broken up by Letang. Jonathan Dolan, the son of Ulf Dolan, the former San Jose Shark.
Boy, look out there. Burns came across the ice on Aston Reese, and you got to be careful in games like this because not everybody is as nice as maybe Burns was there. The bench is appropriately, they said, heads up.
Brent Burns connecting with Noah Gregor. Chip it over the line. Alexander Barabanov. Sharks goal score spins it right in front. Puck available is loose and hoisted high by Gregor.
I don't know how he missed that. He had the old top of the net. He just missed the cage.
The keep by Middleton. Tries to pass it. Was behind Barabanov. Tripped up was Pedersen. Now the scramble. Emerging is Rust. Gets reorganized for the Pens. Goes to Marino and bump off the wall. Looking for Crosby. Stepping up Brian Rust. Two goals, one assist for Rust. Two goals for Rodriguez. Two assists each for Pedersen and Heinen. Penguins leading in shots 22-10. Chad Ruedel flicks it to center. Racing after it was Sam Lafferty. Lafferty along with Radim Zahorna and Kasper Bjorkqvist comprising the Penguins' fourth line. Wondered which way they would go. Now the taxi squad is back. Anthony Angelo also an option. Step up by Matheson. Puck loose in the corner. Bjorkqvist able to locate Matheson. Pass behind Lafferty. Back to Mike Matheson. It's done out of the reach of Lafferty, and that's an icing call against the Pens.
Matheson, a lot of confidence in his skating style. He came into the game saying we got to keep it simple with the long layoff, but he has just been, like everybody else, on his toes. Here he is leading the rush, and he's going to hit that bar to the glove side of Sochenko. A couple of bars, one to end the period, one to start the period here. McGinn hit it at the end.
San Jose a faceoff win. They dominated in that category. That was the only category in the first period. Infinito won 8 of 9. Radim Zahorna out of traffic. Gets it across for Mike Matheson. Has to gain the line. He does. Burrowing in is Kasper Bjorkqvist. Sharks have possession with Andrew Cogliano. Didn't connect with Bonino, but stepping up is Brent Burns. Norris Trophy winner. Burns. Dangle pass Heinen. Unable to do that. Stabbed away. And sent down into Sharks territory. Now Nick Bonino. Over to Jonathan Dolan. Stops at the puck off the edge of the dasher. Simone over to Heinen. Two on two with Rodriguez. Floated over the line. Glove down by Vlasic. Vlasic will hit their head of Rodriguez. Pinching it down the boards. Dumoulin got knocked down. Change of possession. Fired off the wall by Melosh down the distance. And it will not be icing as Letang stops skating. And Letang loses control to Couture. Couture trying to feed it in front. Second attempt and goes off of Barabanov and wide. Alexander Barabanov. Second year in North America, 7 years in the KHL.
Got his fifth here this afternoon.
He's been good.
Yeah.
The bright spots for San Jose. They got off to a great start. They started 4-0, exceeding a lot of expectations. Barabanov. Jolted on the check from Marino. Puck slithers away from Brock McGinn, but he's able to get it deep. McGinn forechecking. Aston Reese drops a shoulder into Hurdle. Barabanov's been out here a while. He's batted down by Drew O'Connor. Work back to the point. Marino over to Pettersson. Pettersson winds, using the end boards. Ricochets over to the corner. Aston Reese trying to cycle with Drew O'Connor. O'Connor gets free. Tried to pass from McGinn. Finds his way back to Marino. Marino dangling, delaying. Now angles down low and saw takeover. The miraculous stop on O'Connor.
Sharks are arguing for a penalty right now. Hurdle, but I think it was his own guy who tripped him up. Look at that mobility by Marino. O'Connor robbed by Sachenko.
We've got a 6-1 score in Pittsburgh in the second period on our AHN scoreboard. We've got the save of the day so far. Zach Sachenko. If it wasn't for him, it'd be 7-1.
No, I know. Right before that, you saw Hurdle get tripped up by his own guy, and the puck comes over to O'Connor. And that was robbery right there by Sachenko. The Penguins had everything going their way in the first period until the end. They hit one post, another post here in the second. Now Sachenko in his first game action.
6'1", 185, 24 years old, undrafted. College hockey 2 years at the University of Alberta, third year pro. He's from Calgary. After James Reimer was pulled, gave up 6 goals in the first. So Zach Sachenko. NHL action. Brian Rust getting the motor going for Pittsburgh. Rust with the pressure from Cogliano. Got it to the front where it's picked off by Erik Karlsson. Karlsson, highest paid player in the league this year in terms of real dollars, not cap hit. He's making $14.5 million. Penguins' next home game is Wednesday against the St. Louis Blues. You can log on to PittsburghPenguins.com or scan the QR code on your screen. The purchase of tickets for Penguins home games this season. That will be the next game for the Blues after they won the Winter Classic in Minnesota yesterday in the frigid temperatures in the state of hockey. It's like -8, -9. The visuals, what an event the NHL put on, the Blues and the Wild. We'll see the Blues here in Pittsburgh. The game will be on TNT. And that will be a tough challenge. St. Louis has been very good. Pens and the Blues on Wednesday, start with back-to-back. Jeffrey VL, number 63. It's written off by Bjorkqvist. Puck comes back to Matheson for the filter it through for Lafferty. Driving to center, Burns. Over to Pettersson. Nothing happens for him. Penguins on the counterattack. Bjorkqvist looking for Zahorna.
Yeah, Burns let Bjorkqvist off the hook again. He's standing up in the neutral zone, but he's not taking these players. There's a hit there.
Kasper Bjorkqvist dangling, fires, and it gets blocked by Radim Šimek.
I find sometimes these players are afraid to step up on a lot of these checks they used to in the old days. Now there's suspensions coming more regularly. Burns has missed a couple.
The Penguins looking for the, well, extra point, but currently have a 6-1 lead here in the second. And as we did with Jake Gensel's autographed ugly sweater in 2019, Geno's version that I am currently wearing will be available for purchase as well. It will be part of the Penguins Legends auction on February 1st at legends.givesmart.com. I believe the site will go live at noon on the 1st. Proceeds will support the Pittsburgh Penguins Foundation. Yes, Geno, more than happy to sign off on that sweater.
Place your bids now.
Oh, yeah.
I'm about to place my bids.
That might.
That beauty.
That's going to be a nice. That's a lot of dough for that one, no? That's beautiful.
Crosby slides it over to Dumoulin. Back to the captain. Hard pass down low. Settled down by Letang. Takes the check from Meyer. Separated from the puck, you know. Charging forward will be Jonathan Dahl, number 76 for San Jose. Dahlin over to Miloszczyk. He's going to knock it down. Got it on goal. Off of DeSmit on the rebound. Dumoulin trying to get it out of the zone. Ryan Rust fishing for it. Logan Couture goes to Middleton. Steps up. Fire save made by DeSmit. And the puck goes up and out of play.
Using your noggin right there, Casey. You might check the mask. Does that hit him up high? Take a look at this play. The Sharks keeping it alive, hitting the offside D. There's a blocker save. And a smooth looking save by Casey DeSmith, challenging at the top of his crease.
Starts the faceoff win, Middleton. Return pass, Carlson, the blast, and the save made by DeSmith. There's Eric Carlson. He's got the haircut, and he has been very good this year. He's just dealt with so many injuries last few seasons. Last time he played over 56 games was 2018. So he's got a bunch of injuries. He's healthy this year. And I mentioned that amount of money that he's making. It's a lot, but he has been excellent. Just looks faster. Back to that skating game that we saw for so many years with the Ottawa Senators. A little display of it right here. Carlson over to Noah Gregor. Snaps a shot and blocked rather easily by Marcus Pettersson. Pettersson loosens the puck, got it to Marino. Sharks trying to sort it out in the neutral zone. Middleton a short pass, hurdle down the middle. Over to Gregor, misfired. Taking the puck away coolly is Marcus Pettersson. Couldn't get it out though, it's intercepted by Carlson. Carlson, two-time Norris Trophy winner, got it into traffic. Carlson getting it back right at the dot. We've got a first penalty upcoming. There's Burns with the drive, and a save made by DeSmith. Andrew Cogliano, delayed penalty. Sharks maintain possession. Alexander Barabanov down to Tomas Hertl. Going to go in front, off the stick, collected now by Cogliano. Sochenko to the bench, extra attacker is on. The touch by Simone, and it's the Sharks with the day's first power play chance.
Going to call a hook here. Carlson pinched down the wall and was trying to make a play to the front of the net. He was hooked up. Get our first power play of the afternoon with 7:29 left in the second period of a 6-1 game. There's Simone. And the stick rode up. The stick of Carlson's right into the glove. And the referee, yes, the whistle does work.
First penalty of the afternoon, and it's Dominic Simone. So the Sharks on the power play, without a power play goal in their last five games. Really struggled last year with the man advantage. Slightly better this year at 17.3%. An 0-for-4 on Thursday in the most recent game against the Philadelphia Flyers.
No Bluger-McGinn combination. You're going to see Lafferty out here with McGinn. Carter won't be killing penalties this afternoon. He's not in the lineup.
And of course, had their big PK streak come to an end in their most recent game in New Jersey, as they had gone 15 games without allowing a power play goal, streak of 39 straight kills. Got a clear here with 1:24 to go in the hooking penalty to Dominic Simone. That was a franchise record, 15 straight games without giving up a power play goal, but still number one in the league, 92.1%. Big part of the story for the Pens and their success this season. Meyer for Couture. Don Marino trapped in the corner. Sharks will work it low to high, and it's Brent Burns. So good at those point shots. Logan Couture to the interior. Able to take it, Timo Meyer. And neatly taken by Zach Aston-Reese, and whips it down. Sharks led by Eric Carlson. Six power play points. Meyer and Hertl, three power play goals apiece. Puck is shoved in. Noah Gregor flying in on the forecheck. Lane Peterson, some power play time along with Nick Bonino. Alexander Barabanov, four forwards. Lone defenseman is Brent Burns, going to try to track this one down. About 28 seconds to go in the Simone penalty. First power play chance of the day for either squad. Alexander Barabanov with the check from Ruedel. Bonino, tight space on the forehand. Winds it all the way around. Noah Gregor, Bonino. Indirectly to Burns. Burns to the slot. Bonino gets it back. Sets it up. Burns with a blast. He scores. There's that shot from the blue line. He's one of the best. Brent Burns on the power play, and it's 6-2.
Wow. That was a little bit frightening, watching that shot come off his stick. He only brought his stick back below his waist. Didn't even bring it back at all. What a shot. Bonino sets the table. And Burns, the whip of the stick, a little bit of a screen in front. It just seemed so effortless. It really did. It just seemed so effortless for Burns. He's been doing it for years. A wicked shot with a lot of pace. And as a San Jose Shark, you go to the dressing room and you're not thinking about winning the game. You're thinking about winning a period. You go in, you're down 6-1. You say, guys, let's come out. Let's be tough. Let's insulate our new goalie. Let's win a period. They're up 1-0 right now.
Are there any guys better at that shot than Brent Burns?
I don't know.
To get that much velocity with so little of a windup, as you said, he's done it for years. Rust goes in, goes to Gensel with a chance and fired wide.
91.3 with a flick of a wrist.
For Brent Burns, is 18 points in 21 career games against the Penguins. Power play goal. And the Sharks are able to capitalize, making it 6-2.
His GM, Doug Wilson, had a pretty good shot from that blue line.
Oh, good point. The Hall of Famer.
Yeah. Yes, recently inducted.
This year. Burns from Bonino and Gregor at 14:27. And it's a four-goal lead for the Pens. Looking for a three-on-two. Evan Rodriguez goes to Hine and flying in, fires another post. That's three for Pittsburgh. Carlson joining the rush. Yell throws a heavy body check behind on Danton Heinen. Puck comes to center circle. Carlson wristed it.
Heinen just got in the way. I think he was just roadkill there, wasn't he?
On the circle, whipped on by Hurdle. Needed out by Dominic Simon. Another three on two, maybe for the Pens. Will fan out. Got a bit crossed up just outside the line. Looking for line change now to pick up for Meyer. Might have a breakaway. He's behind the defense. Cuts in, fires that one wide. Timo Meyer almost made it a three-goal game.
Yeah, good body position.
Tomas Hurdle goes to Burns. Burns drops it off. Tomas Hurdle. Nadim Šimek with a shot. Off traffic in front of Casey DeSmith. Settled down by Burns. Slides it over to Šimek. Starts feeling it right now. Pass by Couture goes all the way through and taken off the wall by McGinn. McGinn, Aston-Reese, 2-on-1 Pittsburgh. Zach Aston-Reese on the forehand. Stopped by Sachenko. And no rebound. The rookie, Zach Sachenko, with some key saves here to give his team somewhat of a chance. And also some help from the post. 6-2 in the second. .325 to go in the second period. It's a 6-2 lead for the Penguins here at TPG Paints Arena. Social media post brought to Point Park University. NHL PR with the note on Jake Gensel. Another game with a point. Points in 14 consecutive games in which he's played. Second Penguins player in the past 10 years to record a point in 14 straight appearances. Joining Pascal Dupuis. Remember that at the end of the 2011-12 campaign? A 17-game point scoring streak for the Duper.
Super Duper. Yeah, he was pretty good with that Crosby unit. Chris Kunitz as well.
And as I mentioned earlier, technically not a streak because of the injury for Jake Gensel. But you can call it what you want. It's points in 14 straight, which he's been in the lineup. He's been the hottest player in the NHL, even scored two goals after the injury in Seattle. 13 goals in 13 games.
And no Olympics coming up, Mirzi. We should reiterate that if you're just tuning in. And the Penguins are going to have to make up five games, I guess, somewhere along the line.
In that slot where the Olympic break was going to be. And it's disappointing news for a guy like Jake Gensel, who certainly would have been on Team USA, among other players in the Penguins lineup and around the NHL who are hoping to play in the Olympics. Russ getting tangled up, drew a penalty. He tried to get that shot off. Both referees on top of it. It will be a holding call on the Penguins of the power play for the first time in the afternoon.
How do you like this play? A self play behind Šimek to himself off the corner wall. Beats the man to the puck and he gets tripped up. That is just, that's using your noggin right there, Brian Rust. Absolutely brilliant stuff there. And not many players, you don't see that. You don't see that much. That's just thinking outside the box there. That's great stuff.
That's three guys on that line with a super high hockey IQ. Crosby, Gensel, and Rust. Penguins of the power play, first time on the day. Scored in 8 of the last 16 games. Of course, Brian Rust back out there. You see him on the left wing side. Evan Rodriguez as the fourth forward. He's at the blue line now. The puck gets past Letang. So it's Radim Šimek, two for holding. Penguins of the power play. Sharks have been good on the PK. Sixth in the league. 3 for 3 the other night against the Flyers. Killed off a lengthy two-man disadvantage and also scored shorthanded. Three shorties on the year. Flying in is Crosby. Crosby down the left wing. Crosby from behind the net. Over to Rust. Ryan Rust trying to work it back. It got blocked by Bonino. It finds its way to the point for Letang. Letang for Crosby. Chris Letang keeping it alive. Walks the line. Goes to the captain. Crosby to the goal line. Gensel with a chance on the stuff attempt denied. And then Rodriguez. He's robbed by Sotchenko. Oh, man. Evan Rodriguez looking for his first career hat trick, and Zach Sotchenko has been quite a story here in the second period.
Well, he's feeling it too. Watch when he makes his save, the final one. This one on Gensel, tries to wrap it in. There's the right toe, and then the big love save on Sotchenko, and that hockey card save led him to do a little dance into the corner, Mirzi. He snapped it out of the air. He went down towards the Zamboni entrance, and you know he was feeling it.
Some highlight real stops here. Second period, NHL debut. Penguins still on the attack on the power play for another minute with Šimek in the box. He's played Crosby, shielding the puck, keeping it in the zone. Rust looking for Gensel. That got broken up by Burns. Around for Rodriguez. Rust, Gensel, taps it over. Here's Crosby stepping up and looking for a stick, either with Gensel or Rust. Rodriguez, dangerous pass for Letang, came out, and Letang will shoot it back in. The Penguins need a change, same thing with San Jose.
Well, Hertl was a mistake, really, because he should have touched that puck in front of Gensel. He was off to the races.
Ogliano to the net, that's answered by DeSmith, gobbled up by Logan Couture. Couture with two shorthanded goals this season.
Well, he's been quiet. Carlson's been quiet in this game here so far. And 800th game in the National Hockey League for the captain, Couture.
Now Mike Matheson drops it back. Dominic Simone all the way over. Heinen, O'Connor settles it down. Fires, he just missed on the far side. Kept alive by Matheson. Stanton Heinen ships it back to Mike Matheson. Spinning, getting it to open ice, and did come out just barely. And it's an offside call against the Pens.
How about these guys getting an opportunity? O'Connor on the power play. Is that a little bit of force here? And Matheson had to go back in and well outside that blue line. And the linesman right on top of it. And there's O'Connor. He was robbed by Sotchenko in this period. That glove hand's been good.
So many good goaltenders. We've seen a bunch of them here this year. Different levels of experience, too. Jeffrey Biel steps up. He gets decked by Aston Reese. He tried to cut back. Penalty is over. Pittsburgh 0-1 on the power play. Time winding down on the second period. We've seen the one goal. That was from Brent Burns on the power play at 14:27. This could be icing as the puck rolls on edge all the way down. And there's the whistle. 15 seconds left.
I gotta think it's maybe benefited the young goaltender here. He wasn't didn't have to think about his first start all day, Mirzi. Sitting on the bench. Look at this hit by Zach Aston Reese. I think we might see that one again by the end of the day, Mirzi. I really do believe that. But for Sotchenko, he's sitting there. He's not expecting to play. Oh, I got to jump in? Yes, you do.
Yeah, maybe that's better.
Yep.
Not thinking about it. Here's Burns. Slides it over. Meyer snaps one on goal. And stopping it is Casey DeSmith.
And he's looking at the referee saying, hey, I got bumped there a little bit. Yeah, but your guy Dumoulin. Barabanov in there. You got a lot of stuff going on. And now for these goaltenders that are challenging, I believe more this year with Jari and Casey Smith, they may tend to get bumped a little bit more. They're on the top of their crease. They're cutting down angles.
Casey DeSmith said he made a slight adjustment with his skates and the way that he laces them up. Been more on his toes the last few games. He's got wins in the last two, stopped 61 of 62.
I've never heard of that one.
Subtle really equipment change.
Yeah.
I don't know. If it's real, if it's mental, but whatever it is, it's worked for him. Last game, December 11th, a 1-0 win in this building against Anaheim. Burns with a shot attempt. Never got through. Crosby on the backhand, hard around, and that will do it for period number two. So, Bob, the Sharks get a power play goal for Brent Burns. Casey DeSmith has 15 saves. Still have 20 minutes to go, but it's the Penguins leading comfortably 6-2.
Yeah, and they, you know, it's... You see that with a 6-1 lead. You didn't play their best second period here and just looking to build in here in the third.
Not too bad for the first game since it's Gensel. He scores! High into the inside. Rodriguez, another chance. He scores! He can't be stopped. He fires. He scores! And this onslaught continues. Brian Rust is back. Right in front, Bjorkvist with a chance. It's loose, and they score.
Everybody remembers that first goal in the National Hockey League. And I think Bjorkvist has got it right now, and good for him. Congratulations.
6-2 score after 40 minutes of play. Two goals from Evan Rodriguez. Let's take a look at the shot chart for E-Rod. Six attempts on the afternoon. Five shots on goal, one of them missed. Couple of goals for Rodriguez. His career year continues. 12 goals. What a story he has been. One of the best stories for the Pens.
And what about this story for this youngster, Zach Sachenko? He played in the Western Hockey League for 3 years. From Moose Jaw Mirzi. After that, he said, I'm not coming back. I'm going to college. I'm going to go to the University of Alberta.
Had to be Canadian college.
Yep. I'm going to go to Canadian college. University of Alberta. I'm going to take advantage of what they offer there in Canadian Major Junior Hockey. I'm going to get an education. This doesn't mean I'm not going to make it to the NHL, but I'm going to try a different route. They've got a great program there. So his family went there. He did that. You know, he went to the combines in the 2000s, right before the 2016 draft. Thought he was going to get drafted. He watched every pick go by. Never got drafted. Went undrafted. He said, yeah, that had a lot to do with my decision and what I did.
Look at this odd pair. Came back into the crease, and the Sharks score just 20 seconds into the third period.
That
big
was weird.
Slingshot bounce off the end wall back into the crease. The Smith couldn't find it, and San Jose makes it 6-3.
And once again, as I was just talking, the life of a goaltender can be up and it can be down. And take a look at this one. Goes off the back wall, side of the net, hits to Smith. Russ can't stop it. If Russ couldn't do anything wrong, he couldn't get a stick on that puck in front of his own net to help his buddy out. But that puck sometimes just doesn't bounce the way you think it might. Like a lacrosse ball, it's round. It doesn't bounce the way you think it should, Mirzi. And that puck is certainly, with all those edges and everything else, with a net in the way, finds its way behind Casey DeSmith. And interesting, it's getting a little bit uncomfortable right now if you're a Penguin player and a Penguin fan. It's pretty quiet all of a sudden.
Well, you know, it was set in the dressing room for San Jose. Get a quick one. They get a fortuitous bounce, 20 seconds in. And the Sharks make it 6-3. Starting to tilt the ice a little bit. They had that power play goal. They got a penalty kill in the second. Certainly played a lot better than they did in the first. And they're back in on the attack with Timo Meier bouncing puck, and he couldn't swat that one down.
And with the business student in the other end there now, that's Sachenko. Maybe he's going to get a little nervous thinking to himself, hey, we're actually in the game here all of a sudden. I can't let in anything else. But what a great story for the kid, and obviously a smart man decided to maybe hockey wasn't going to be the way, and if it wasn't, I'm going to have something in my back pocket. And I really admire that.
That's a great point. Had to play Canadian university because he had played major junior in Canada, yep. Therefore couldn't play U.S. college, so University of Alberta. We've seen a few players over the years play Canadian university and get to the NHL level. Joel Ward comes to mind, University of Prince Edward Island.
It's a tough route and not route for many, but certainly commendable.
So Zach Sachenko, first National Hockey League game. Made some big saves. Routine one there on Chad Ruedel. Sharks kicking off this four-game road trip. Next up, they'll be in Detroit on Tuesday. Aiden Hill is normally the backup. He's on a conditioning assignment right now.
I think he's wearing my old linemate's number, 36. Wasn't that Jeff Hodgers? Number 36?
Oh, yeah, I think so.
How does a goalie get number 36?
Well, usually in the 30s.
Wow.
I don't know about 36, but there it is. It's been working for him, Zach Sachenko. It's been good. Dominic Simone at the side of the net. Could take that one cleanly. Working around the boards to Matheson. Poked back to the line. Rodriguez hustles over. It's off of Dahlin to center circle. Ulf Dahlin, his father. Another one of your former teammates. Now a message from DQE Communications.
DQE is a fiber optic internet and data access provider for businesses. Visit us at dqecom.com.
Ulf Dahlin, yeah, he kind of invented that position, that 10-2, they call it, when the players put their skates together and skate across the ice. He used to do that all the time before really anybody did it with the regularity that he did.
Great hockey player, great man. One of my favorite players to play with, for sure.
Played over 900 games in the NHL. Dolan. And now it seems like everybody does that, opening up the skate blades using the edges.
Yeah.
John Marino's so good at that. Crosby, of course, the master. Crosby, Rust, Gensel pouring in. Nothing happens there for the Pens on the attack. Now Lane Peterson will take it wide. He's met quickly by Letang. Shoveled in. Jonah Gadjevic, number 42, joined by Jeffrey Viel. Viel taps it up the boards. Middleton pumps it in behind. Gadjevic knocked down to his knees. Dumoulin defending for Pittsburgh along with Letang. Side of the net taken by Gensel. Floated off the wall to Rust. Ryan Rust, three-point game. On a four with multi-point efforts this afternoon for the Pens. They've got 13 players with at least 1 point. Aston Reese is in on the line. Looks, fire, save, rebound, O'Connor. He's denied by Sachenko. Puck scooped up by Middleton. Carlson, Middleton, Timo Meier as the Sharks fan out. Meier, pass finds his way over. Carlson, drive, he scores. Posted in, Erik Karlsson. It is 6-4.
He's another guy that can shoot it. He's had a pretty good year. The Penguins have a chance to get a couple of cracks at one end. Sachenko makes the saves. The puck comes down the other way. Here's Zach Aston-Reese, a big fat rebound. O'Connor can't score. He hasn't been able to put it behind the netminder. And here is Carlson. He's able to step right into this. Again, there was some screen there. I'm not sure it touched anything on the way in, but Carlson was able to measure up. Yeah, it was touched in the high slot, was it not? Almost looked like it went off a stick in the high slot there, guys. If you want to take one more look at that. And Mike Sullivan says, let's get back to what we're doing. Plant our toes, get the pucks deep. Let's get in the D. Let's see if there's going to be a little tip right in the high slot, I think. Mirzy, right there? Yeah, no doubt. That puck was tipped in. Well, it may not be Carlson, maybe somebody else.
Jacob Middleton.
Okay.
His defensive partner, the defenseman.
What was he doing there?
Yeah, I was just thinking the same thing. Nice hands.
Wow. What a tip it was. And there's a ton of time left.
We'll wait on the official scoring on the goal. Carlson will factor in, two-time Norris Trophy winner. And as we said, there's a lot of hockey to be played. And around this time, we have seen some wild scores around the NHL with teams coming out of various breaks. But do not go away. It's a 6-4 game. Both teams have used their timeouts now. Ryan Dumoulin. Under pressure from Nieto. Lafferty drives it over. Zahorna along with Letang enters the attacking zone. He's met by Vlasic and the puck is shuffled around. Nick Bonino, along with Nicholas Melosh, who hit from Lafferty. Marc-Edouard Vlasic. Melosh connects with Nieto. Over the line with Timo Meier. Meier looking. Couldn't go through Ruweedle. Watched him closely. Matheson. Head manning for Rodriguez. Edwards forging through the neutral zone. Hurdle goes across to Šinek. Defenseman jumping up on the attack. Raheem Šinek loves this one down. Swatted at it. Stick came up. Now back over. Score! Logan Couture. Penguins are looking for a high sticking penalty. They're not going to get one. And it's a one-goal game.
Well, they just played an 8-7 game, the Sharks, so they know all about the ability to get back in a hockey game. This play goes to the front of the net. Ruweedle takes a stick up high, doesn't draw the penalty, and Couture is able to bang it in as that puck comes. Look at all the Penguins focused on the puck, and nobody picks up Couture. He's wide open. Beats Casey DeSmith underneath the glove and over the pad as all the Penguins are just looking at the puck. So in game 800 for Couture, we have a 6-5 game. The Sharks score right after the Penguins call a timeout.
13th year in San Jose. Goals in three consecutive games for their captain, Logan Couture. Three straight in the third. It is 6-5. And now now guilty of icing. Crosby looks back at the linesman, thought he won that race. We're going to have a face-off in the Penguin zone.
Six goals in the first period. That tied a franchise record. By the way, last time when they did score that six goals, they lost 10-6. So six, so it's like a six in the first period is not a good thing, apparently.
I was going to say, this game is reminding me of the Devil game last year where the Penguins nearly blew a six-goal lead in this building. Just a bizarre game. And I talked about it back in the first period. The Penguins have been in this situation before, big leads early on, and then they let their guard down, and the team is able to claw back and make it interesting. Yes, it's difficult to sustain that level of play for a full 60 minutes for any team on any given day. Well, the Penguins trying to get back to their A game here in the third.
Don't tell me momentum doesn't mean anything. When you start the first period, I mean, the Penguins had all that momentum, and you asked yourself, how can one team be so good and one team look so bad? Well, that's never the case, right? It's somewhere in between. And now what you're seeing now, it's somewhere in between. But the Penguins better find themselves here somehow, some way. And it might be a big hit. It could be. You don't know what it's going to be. Maybe it's that block. Maybe it's a penalty kill or a big save. But Sochenko made a bunch of big saves.
Exactly.
This game could have been 8-1.
I was going to say, it's amazing what a rookie goaltender can do and some saves can do for your team as the tag of the Penguins pour in. Pass doesn't find its way to Gensel. Letang with possession in the neutral zone. Now a 6-5 score. Letang will 9-iron it in. And back to hop on it. Maybe Erik Karlsson. Again out here along with Aston Reese and Drew O'Connor. This is the only line for the Penguins that is not on the score sheet, but had some glorious chances. McGinn hit a post. O'Connor was robbed by Sochenko. A couple of tip tries for Zach Aston Reese today. Shoot in from San Jose to Smith. Pass it over to O'Connor, trying to win the battle. But jam it forward for McGinn, and he will bank it out to center ice. In stride is Aston Reese, joined by O'Connor. Tried to pass, but it's blocked by Burns. Aston Reese takes a hard check. Through O'Connor, trying to sift it out of there. Deflects over to Burns, had to move it quickly, and does. And it will find its way out to center past Pettersson. Gadjevich pursues. Sharks will shoot in, courtesy of Lane Peterson. Both teams are making line changes here. 14 minutes to go in the third. Four unanswered goals from San Jose. Three of them here in the third period, and it's 6-5.
Yeah, and a couple of players, a guy, one in Carter and one in Bluger, they're pretty good at shutting down hockey games for your hockey team when you got a lead, and they're not available to the Penguins here.
Here comes Sam Lafferty dangling in. Zahorna trying to find it. He couldn't. And now the puck available. Half boards, Bonino. Chopped away by Lafferty. Zahorna trying to use his size and strength. Malosh gets it over to Cogliano. Skips one past Matheson and out the center red. One thing with San Jose, they have dominated in the faceoff circle. Bonino has won 14 of 15. Did so through two periods of play. Puck slithers out to center. Penguins reload with Ruedel. He'll whip it in. Fans getting engaged. Bringing up the noise level. Middleton chips it forward for Barabanov. Not the first Sharks goal this afternoon. Play is broken up by Rodriguez. Area pass, trying to skate into it, Simon. And wins the battle against Karlsson. Gets it back in front and shot wide by Heinen. Penalty upcoming. Karlsson got tangled up.
Yeah, he's wondering why there's not a penalty on him. Simon stole the puck from behind on him. And maybe it will be Simone who's going to the
thinking.
Box. Okay. He is going to the box again. There it is. Away with the initial one. That really wasn't called, but this one here got caught underneath the arm of Karlsson, who went down right in front of the referee. That one he was not going to let go. And the Penguins, in their top penalty killing units, got perhaps their biggest one of the year.
Taking a hit over the past couple of games now. San Jose 1-for-1 on the power play. Quick shot from Dahl on that far side. And now another penalty is going to be called. Delayed call. Rodriguez breaks in. Fires. Fought off by Sochenko. There's the whistle. And that will do it for the San Jose power play chance. Lasted only 14 seconds. And we're going to have some 4-on-4 hockey.
Yeah, Couture came underneath the stick.
San Jose penalty number 39.
Let's take a look. And McGinn's going to try to play the puck. There it is. The stick goes right underneath the hands with one hand on your stick reaching like that.
What a faux pas that was for Couture, and then the chance going the other way. Rodriguez looking for that hat trick.
Penguins just got their first shorthanded goal of the season in their most recent game, December 19th, courtesy of Teddy Bluger. Well, Bob, you make a great point. There's one guy that Penguins have really relied on in a defensive role, protecting leads. But same thing with Jeff Carter, Brian Boyle.
Yep.
Those players out. 4-4 hockey, turnover. Crosby couldn't settle it down, and it's stolen away by Middleton. Middleton leads the charge for San Jose. Puck is behind Hurdle, finds his way in deep. Shipped along by Matheson for Marino. John Marino trying to shake the check of Hurdle. Find some refuge behind the goal. 1:15 to go in the Simone penalty. 4-on-4 hockey. Crosby rockets that one across for Matheson. Matheson over to Letang. Pass too hot to handle. Scooped up by Šimek. Turns away from Crosby. Penguins want a line change. Sharks doing the same thing. Burns will get it back from Timo Meier. Burns, lead pass. Unable to accept it at the line was Gregor. Collects it on the far side. Got lined up by Dumoulin. Sidestep the hit. And the puck is deep. Letang. Brian Dumoulin connects with Rust. In over the line along with Dumoulin. Skates into it. Turns. Dumoulin down the wall for Rodriguez. Two goals on the day. Evan Rodriguez strips to the top. Nearly lost control. Played to himself. Look at the dangling. Chopped away by Burns. Now Letang looking, firing off the glove of Sachenko. Jumped on by Rust. Rust to the circle. Gathered in by Rodriguez. Rattles that one around the glass. Rust has Dumoulin open. 4-on-4 for 13 seconds. Letang steps up, tried the shot. And that was disrupted by Gregor.
That was making a change. Yeah, Rodriguez didn't recognize it.
And pour right back in. Here's Letang looking, firing. Sachenko. A body save, still 1 second left. And the Simone call, and then it will be an abbreviated power play chance for Pittsburgh.
Well, Rodriguez, like he's got this puck on a string. There's one, there's two. And that, he's just having fun with it, isn't he? So creative, so handsy, so confident a hockey player right now, Rodriguez. And the Penguins are gonna have a power play here. 1 second, it'll be a 14 second power play.
See what they want to do with the personnel. Dominic Simone's gonna do, he steps out of the box right now, but it's yet another faceoff win for San Jose and a clear. Simone is able to get enough of it in the neutral zone, and the Penguins will get organized at center. Simone stays on, motoring in is Letang. Double team, lost control, Nieto on the clear for the Sharks.
And that's that. We play some 5-on-5, and there's a half a period here in the balance. And a game on the line.
Pittsburgh falling 0-for-2 on the power play. John Marino trying to collect in the corner. Marino going below the goal line by Gensel. Andrew O'Connor. Here's Tomas Hertl. Hertl has to spin it over to the backhand. Pocket picked by O'Connor. O'Connor by himself. Now gets joined by McGinn. Steps up with a shot. Getting a chunk of that with Sachenko. And the puck out of play. Another chance for Brock McGinn.
He'll be a household name by the end of the day here. Sachenko. And the Penguins trying to go up high over the Calgarian. This one, Brock McGinn, who hit a goal post late in the first period when Reimer was in net and the score was 6-1. That would have made it 7-1.
Shot from a point. Goes around the boards. Drew Weedle on the hold. Behind the net, Drew O'Connor. O'Connor centering pass, McGinn turning. Backhander never got through. The block by Vlasic. Pounded off the wall by Couture. Sharks able to complete the line change past the halfway point in this third period. 3 goals in the third for San Jose, making things very interesting in Pittsburgh. Classic over to Šimek. Slips it around. Peterson for Timo Meier. He gets leaned on by McGinn. Both players topple down. Zach Aston-Reese, room to skate, steps into the attacking zone. Wrist shot stopped by Sachenko. Battle ensues near boards. Šimek trying to find it. Simone on the steal. Nice player win the battle. Gets it to open ice. Now turning Rodriguez over to Pedersen. Shot. That was deflected back over and right through the goal mouth.
If Sachenko had got back quicker, he would have knocked it into his own goal. Wow, a great play by Simone to step on the puck to really get that puck dislodged and available for the Penguins in the offensive zone. But Sachenko, very fortunate there.
Carlson, hard pass, Noah Gregor in, fires, that goes high and wide. Puck goes past Dahlin out to center. Jacob Middleton steps up. Took the check from Lafferty. Now Dumoulin is out here with Letang. Big contact, Bjorkqvist.
Bjork just saw it. Carlson pinching in, he got a body on him.
Letang, toss on net, stop, rebound, Lafferty to the front. Over the circle, Letang with the shot, kicked away by Sachenko. Stepping out now is Erik Karlsson, jammed away neatly by Dumoulin, but the Penguins want a line change. San Jose changing the personnel, they stretch it out to Cogliano, wrist shot, stop, rebound, but Nino missed the target.
Wow.
Crosby over to Rust, lobs it in. Penn's captain, first player in after it. He gets leaned on by Nicholas Melosh. Digging it out is Rust, 3 points on the day. Matheson with a shot, off the glass. Swinging his stick was Crosby, Bonino couldn't recover it. Rust does, he's got it, takes a look. Brian Rust, going to set up on the attack for Pittsburgh. Matheson trying to go backdoor for Crosby, didn't connect. Lou Weedle keeps it in the shark zone. Down behind the net, Gensel, he's going to walk out. Gensel, Lou Weedle, the drive, and it's blocked by Nieto. Nick Bonino's seen enough. He tries to clear softly off the glass and out the center as both teams are changing on the fly. Calmly getting back is Drew O'Connor. O'Connor now with the Jets on through center. O'Connor is swarmed by Sharks. Penguins are changing the defense. Here comes Timo Meier. Meier closing in to Couture. Looks, fires, blocker save made by DeSmit.
O'Connor realized that puck's got to go deep. If it doesn't, it goes the other way.
Batted forward, Acid Reese, a chance, and denied by Sachenko.
Oh, that was a big save. He got the right toe out at the last second, and a puck that looked like it was destined for inside the post.
Now Burns with a shot, catches glass. It is a wild one today in Pittsburgh. 6-5 score. Shoot in wide of Sachenko. Danton Heinen, lone player in there for Pittsburgh. Brent Burns with possession of the puck for San Jose. Smacks it off the glass to center. Dumoulin for Letang. Letang gains the line. Sails that one into the gear of Sachenko, who is looking like Sawchuck.
Ooh.
What a performance from the rookie.
I like it.
Giving his team a chance.
I like it.
6-5 score. Zach Aston Reese trying to get to the highlight reel. Stopped by the pad of Sachenko.
Well, there's Reimer on the left. He started today. He exited after six in the first period, and then this guy comes in. Sachenko, that play there, Simone. Boy, I thought if Sachenko got there quicker, he would have knocked it in. And then how about this guy, snake bit, a career high six shots. That was a beautiful save. He made a nice play to chip it by between the blue lines when he shortened up on his stick. Good speed, just can't buy one.
Letang off a stick. Wide of Sachenko, who made 18 saves. That was deflected and steered away to the netting by Sachenko with the goaltender's paddle. Sachenko hasn't given up a goal, 18 of 18 just prior to that one. Now the six goals, as Bob said, given up by James Reimer in the first period. He was done. Sachenko has been excellent.
There's the last one there. It's where you put the rebounds, try to get him out of harm's way, but now he needs his team to get one more. He's done his job. The Sharks are trying to do theirs.
Keep by Letang. Here is Danton Heinen. Doubles it in behind for Rodriguez. Rodriguez is checked quickly by Middleton. Carlson works it back to center, and it's Alexander Barabanov. Smith trying to play it on the short hop. Letang slaps the puck by everybody. This will go down wide of Sachenko. There's the whistle for an icing call with 5:54 to go in the third. Now we'll take a look at the Edgar Snyder and Associates hit of the game. Bob, you said might see him again later on in the day. Sure enough.
There it is. Oh, that was nice. Wow. He can hit, and he likes to hit, and he's the Penguins' leading hitter. He'd like to score, though, too.
Well, six shots on goal. Even the Penguins, career high for Zach Aston Reese. Penguins controlling. Losing possession at center, and now it's Meier who drives in. Meier for Hurdle, looking up the stick, and it was loose and went wide. Right there was Logan Couture. Tap to the middle, Hurdle with the shot, stop on the rebound, Meier. Sharks loading up here. Three of their best players, Couture, Meyer, and Tomas Hertl. Heinen empty-handed, kicked it along, as Crosby will skate it out to relieve that pressure. Bought some time. Russ.
Too many men on the ice. Russ got hit by a player jumping on the ice for Couture, who was still on the ice. And it was Cogliano who made contact. And clearly too many men on the ice.
Gensel trying to steal it from Meyer. Meyer's tired. He will head off. Pittsburgh moving to D to D Pedersen. Nice tip in from through O'Connor. Scampering down the boards was McGinn. Carlson connects with Cogliano. Cogliano floats it down the wing. Nieto with a toss on goal. To Smith with the answer. Off the glass, but not out. Carlson maintains his balance, keeps that puck in the zone. Sharks spread out here. Bonino, quick shot, and that's shut down by Casey DeSmith. We're talking about the goalie at the other end, but Casey DeSmith called upon, and he slams the door a couple of times. Close call to side of the net. Couture nearly tied it up.
Yes, it's nice to see the little ones on hand today. And speaking of a little one, Brian Boyle not in the game today, and for good reason, because he and his wife, Lauren, welcomed their newest little one, Callum Boyle, into the world yesterday on New Year's Day. Everyone's doing fine, Brian. Big hello, big congrats. We'll see you soon.
That's awesome, Dan. Thank you very much. Congratulations to the Boyle family.
Awesome.
Pittsburgh, a big face-off into the defensive zone. Rambling out to center is Zach Aston-Reese. Now Brock McGinn down that far wing. Shifty move, tried to get to the middle for O'Connor. Shot attempt, never got through to Sachenko. Taken coolly by Burns. Good block on the pass attempt. Aston-Reese has to try to find it in neutral territory. Erik Karlsson will leave it for Timo Meyer, who's been relatively quiet here today. Meyer. Tried to flip it across off a stick, and that's a souvenir.
Not intentional, so didn't play the puck. Just tried to interrupt the pass there, so not a penalty when you do it that way. Well, this is going to be a real battle right down to the end here. In a game we thought that was well over.
Right off that faceoff, Crosby's looking back for a penalty call off the draw. Smith had to be ready. Sent around to Crosby. Crosby, rink wide for Brian Rust. Rust with 2 goals, 1 assist here this afternoon. And scored 6 times in period number one. They had a 6-1 lead. It is now 6-5 at PPG Paints Arena. The Pens return after being off for 2 weeks, looking for an 8th consecutive victory. The puck is bumped out by San Jose. They'll make a wholesale change and back to retrieve as Letang. Letang along with Dumoulin. Rodriguez, Danton Heinen, Dominic Simon, the forwards for Pittsburgh. It's snapped in by Dumoulin. Sachenko will watch as the puck goes around, trying to play it as Vlasic. He gets jammed up along the wall. Simon getting free, and he just threw a penalty. Delayed call. Rodriguez flips it back to Ruedel. Mike Matheson, extra attacker is Crosby. Locates Rodriguez, looks and fires, missed it high and wide. It will go all the way back. Sharks didn't touch, so the delayed penalty situation will continue with the Smith at the bench.
May have been Nieto with the stick. I don't know how you can do that. You're putting your team short for the rest of the game. You need a goal here as Matheson steps on the puck and goes down hard.
There's the touch from San Jose. Matheson will dust himself off.
Number 83, 2 minutes, hooking.
And it is Nieto.
Simone wins another battle. There's Nieto just reaching once again, just like Couture did when his team was on the power play and they were down by 1 goal. You come all the way back and then you take these penalties. Crosby got clipped right here. No call, right off the faceoff. The stick goes up high. And the Sharks got a good chance off that faceoff in the offensive zone.
It was 0-2 on the power play, 2 shots on goal. That second chance was only for 14 seconds. Maybe the Pens have an opportunity to put this one away. Evan Rodriguez inching in, goes behind the back for Letang. Letang, as Crosby has an option and he goes there. Rust is in front all along, gets the shot off, and that's denied by Sachenko.
Well, he missed with the poke check, but he didn't miss with his left pad. He made another big save.
Ryan Rust gets to the puck first. Bouncer, and it's whacked out of there by Cogliano. Always have to be aware of him. Short-handed, only Brad Marchand with more short-handed goals among active players. And Andrew Cogliano. Cogliano going to the bench. That's Tomas Hertl, the penalty-killing effort. Classic in Carlson, joined by Noah Gregor. Chris Letang at the point. The first to Rusten, spin it back to Letang. Letang, Rodriguez, right in front, score! Hats off to E-Rod! Evan Rodriguez makes it 7-5.
Well, if you're going to take the penalty, you're going to put this Penguins power play on the ice, and one of the hottest players on that team is Rodriguez. And that'll be a first for him. As Letang found him the puck. Let's take a look at all three here. Patience early on in the hockey game to get things rolling for the Penguins. And then a backhand deke against Reimer in the first period. And then Rodriguez takes his feed from Letang. Off the left skate, back to the stick, right through Jake Guentzel, which is a big feat on its own to get it by Guentzel. And right by that left pad of the netminder. And there it is, first career hat trick, it appears. That's a lot of hats, Mirzy.
And they're still flying in Pittsburgh. Evan Rodriguez, first career hat trick. 13 goals, the career year continues. And while they're cleaning up the hats, I want to go back to something. If you watch In the Room, and if you're a Penguin fan, I don't know why you wouldn't watch In the Room. Go back to the first episode last season, Hockey Ops meeting. They were trying to figure out who should the Penguins sign, who should they acquire, and they had a couple of options. It was Mike Sullivan who said, this guy can score. He really lobbied for him. This guy will put the puck in the net if we give him an opportunity. We saw glimpses of it last year. And we are seeing what Evan Rodriguez can do, what he did at Boston University, 60-point scorers last year in college. But you got to give credit, the great access on In the Room, you got to give credit to Mike Sullivan. He was speaking at the time with Jim Rutherford and his staff and said, this guy can score. He believed in him. And Mike Sullivan was right.
Well, he certainly was. And a lot of talk with his old coach about Rodriguez, his college coach. Mike Sullivan, here comes the goalie. He was on his way out here as the Sharks went offside. You know, this gives the coach a little bit in his back pocket here for the next game. You know, hey guys, we play this way, we're successful. We play this way, we're not that successful. You know, we got to get pucks deep. Do what we did in the first period. So it looks like the Penguins, looks like, they might get out of here with 2 points, but there's still a ways to go here. And the goaltender, Sachenko, still trying to get to the bench.
He raced over there, but they're going to drop it again in the neutral zone. So Sachenko is going to go back to at least the slot area. Evan Rodriguez, first career hat trick. He's got 15 points in the last 14 games. Another point for Brian Rust as he gets the secondary helper. So it's a 4-point return for Brian Rust after missing 11 consecutive games. Penguins with possession here. Crosby is open. Puck skips on him. Sachenko had to backpedal into the crease. And the Sharks now trying to march through center. We got 1:38 to go and a wild one this afternoon in Pittsburgh. And now a 7-5 lead, a little more breathing room for the home team. Couture bumps it back. Erik Karlsson, there goes Sachenko. That was the first goal he allowed. Cleared forward, Guentzel couldn't get it out. Deflects back to Couture, off the scramble. Burns taps it over to Karlsson. Feed right to the circle, cut off by Letang. Has an opening, guides it to center, eludes the grasp of Guentzel. Sharks are back in with Couture. Logan Couture, 800th NHL game, goes a hurdle, tipped off the post. Turning is McGinn. Dumoulin, high up into the atmosphere, and back out to the neutral zone. It's fielded by Karlsson. 56 to go. Timo Meier to the high slot, cut off Rodriguez for four. It's wide of the net.
I'd like to say you're going to get another chance at getting four, but you may never get another chance at getting four. Ask Jeff Carter that, who got four against Buffalo last year.
Ask Crosby and Malkin. Yeah. Never done it.
Never done it, and Rodriguez had a chance to put four on the board. How about this one here? Hurdle tips it off the goalpost. Guess what? That goes in, and the Sharks lose 7-6. You know who gets the loss?
That's right. We've seen that a few times.
Sachenko would have got the loss. Always. You talk about something that is not right.
It would have been unfair. 40 seconds to go. Right in front, missing it was Barabanov. Hard off the glass by Dumoulin. Knocked down by San Jose. Hurdle. Now Barabanov. Lobs it in behind. There's Letang station. Over to Aston Reese. Skips it down with a two-goal lead. Penguins will be able to make the line change. 18 seconds to go. Burns. Broken up by Gensel. There's Brian Rust with a five-point game. He's got it! Brian Rust! Give him the HT! 8-5!
Well, they'll be selling hats in Pittsburgh next week. There's no way there can be any left. And a career high, 5 points tonight, or today, for Brian Rust. Here it is. Quick shot against Reimer in the first period. Here he is from out high through a screen off a body. And then the final into an empty cage. Little move against Burns, tried to stand him up. He was able to find the twine.
Fifth career hat trick for Brian Rust. Missed 11 games with the injury. He gets back in there. I said earlier, he had been playing very well. Getting back to his game. Had 9 points and 12 prior to getting hurt on Long Island in the warm-up. Number one Cochrane Expressway players of the game. Couple of hat tricks today for the Pittsburgh Penguins. First for Evan Rodriguez, fifth for Brian Rust. And you go back to Dupuis and Sikora at the Igloo in 2008. I was doing that game on the other side. It was against the Islanders. A lot of hats on that night. I can't believe there were that many left
I know.
For Brian Rust. That was a lot of the second one.
I don't know what to say, but when I look down and see people still with hats on down there, Mirzi.
What were they waiting for?
What are they waiting for now?
Oh, wow. What a game. It was tense. A little too tense. But the Pittsburgh Penguins have won 8 in a row. They're back, and the winning streak continues.
That was fun. We got a player with his first in the National Hockey League, couple with hat tricks. And a youngster on the other side who didn't get a win or a loss, who made a name for himself, Mirzi, here today. And the first time we haven't played in 2 weeks, it was a great day of hockey.
It wasn't 8-7. Had to sweat it out a little bit, though. It was 8-5. And Casey DeSmith wins in 3 straight starts. Evan Rodriguez, Brian Rust, hat tricks. So much to discuss. We'll have much more when we come back. Pens win it 8-5.